Hey guys, it's George. Welcome to today's video. Today we're here to rate and review TXT's Yeonjun's Airport Fashion. I had no expectations of this. Typed TXT Yeonjun Airport Fashion into Google, into Pinterest, into Twitter. I'm shocked. I'm shook. I'm amazed. Yeonjun was already my bias in TXT, but after researching for this video, I'm just like, honey, you skyrocketed to that top spot. To the top spot, for sure. If you are new to this series, let me explain how it works. I've got six of Yeonjun's looks here on my laptop. I'm gonna go through, talk references, designers, silhouettes, and more. And then as it's a review, I'll be rating each look out of 10. 10 wings, because we're at the airport. Yeonjun, look one. 10 wings. 10 wings. 10 fucking wings. Wow. This shot as well. Perfect. The coat billowing open as he walks. Model, runway, working it. I'm shook. Yeonjun is wearing this beautiful leather trench coat. And let me tell you, I've wanted a leather trench coat for fall for so long. This year was gonna be the year. Thinking about it, how much am I gonna invest in this piece? Yeonjun has sold me on the dream. This coat is beautiful. You can see that it's got this slightly oversized fit. That set-in shoulder, which is a seam like this, where it just comes straight down, is slightly past his natural shoulder. We've got the epaulettes, that oversized collar and the pal. It doesn't look like there is a gun flap in the front here, but we can see that it's got the wrist straps, it's got that waist belt that a classic trench has. This has a lot of those classic trench features, but it's this beautiful black buttery leather. Oh, so good. The length of this coat is perfect on him. It's hitting him just below the knee. It's like the perfect oversized fit. The way it billows in the wind as he walks, it's stunning. If I was creating this coat though, I would change the lining. For me, the white lining in this like stripe motif, it's not doing it for me, and it's like the pickiest fucking thing to pull out. I know it is, but if I go back to my buying days, my designing days, I would not have put a white lining in this coat. For me, it's just too much of a contrast. I don't like the stripe of the fabric. It would have looked so much better in like a soft black or just black, all black. The styling on the rest of this outfit is very simple, but it's very effective. We've got that black roll neck jumper tucked into those jeans. These jeans are a really nice slim cut. They're a nice mid wash with that light wash panel on the thigh. And then he's got that very simple black belt with the statement silver buckle. It just works very harmoniously. It lets the coat do the talking. Yeonjun's looks then been finished off with these slightly pointed black Chelsea boots, the very thin, understated wire glasses, and then that beautiful black statement bag. If you've watched this series for a long time, you know I'm here for a statement black accessory. Black accessories all the way. I think this might be that Saint Laurent bag we've seen a lot of male idols carrying. It's so beautiful. It works with the look perfectly. I'm also zooming in on those double-double earrings. I'm ready for the double-double. Yeonjun look one. Shock horror, it is 10 wings from me. The statement leather coat, the beautiful styling underneath to let the leather coat be the star of the show. I want this outfit. Yeonjun look two, again, this is another fire picture glaring straight into the camera as he's coming down the escalator like, oop, you got me, bitch. I'm here for this. The colors of this outfit work perfectly. This really beautiful mid-green shade in the V-neck. I really like the fact that this is a fine knit and he's tucked it into this pair of wide leg jeans that sit right at the top of his hips and come down into this wide leg, and they've been rolled up over those black chunky square toe boots to really frame them nicely. The boots, such a fucking great pair of boots. You can't beat a good pair of boots in winter. It's definitely something worth investing in. The shade of the jeans is like that really nice off-white ecru kind of color, and we can see it's got this really nice top stitching detail around all of the pockets, and it's nice to see that it's in like a tonal brown instead of being like black or orange. That wouldn't have worked here. We can see he's got the same belt as well as his last look. To me, it looks like it's just like a diesel jean belt. It's very subtle, but we can still get that like hint of diesel on like the heavy silver clasp. I can't quite work out what the blue cuffs are peeking out from under the jumper. Part of me thinks that it's just part of the jumper that could be sewn into the inside, because where it is a V-neck, we're not really getting a hint that there's anything underneath. So I think it is a cuff sewn into the cuff of the jumper. I really like it. It also would have looked great without it. It is just a design feature of the jumper, but it doesn't like make or break the look for me. Yeonjun has accessorized his look with this really nice navy blue beret. Every time someone pulls off a beret, it makes me upset because I cannot. And then he's got this oversized black tote bag. Personally, for me, the bag is not my favorite. However, it does work with the outfit. It ties into the boots, the belt, the bag. It works. It's just, that comes down to personal taste, but it works with the outfit, so I can't really like take a mark off. So Yeonjun look two, this is another 10 wings from me. His style's really come through. I had no expectations. So honestly, when I was researching this, I was just sat at the computer like, don't forget, if you're enjoying today's video, hit that subscribe button and turn on the post notification bell so you never miss a future upload. Also, YouTube have just introduced a brand new feature called Super Thanks. This is a way to say thank you and tip your favorite creators. So if you're really enjoying today's video and you would like to make a donation to my channel, it would be hugely, hugely appreciated. Anyway, let's dive in to look three. Look three, bangs. Look three, slaps. This is insane. The different textures of black, the silhouette, and then that contrasting bright yellow hair. I'm so here for it. It's so fucking good. I feel like Yeonjun and me have a very similar taste when it comes to clothes. If he ever wants to go shopping, hook me up. Hook me up. Yeonjun is wearing a black shirt jacket that has this very slim, streamlined Cuban collar. It's then been done up all of the way. You can see that there's that chest pocket on the left side, and you can see that he's got that classic shirt cuff detail, and it's got those large buttons around the cuff and also in the placket of the shirt. And then underneath, it's been layered with that black lacy mesh t-shirt. It's just different textures of black and an all black look. It just really elevates it. And then I think my favorite part is the silhouette of the trousers. The trousers are hitting him right on top of the hips where his natural waist would be. It's belted and it's this really beautiful tapered slim cut that finish just below where his ankle will be. And I believe he's got the Dr. Martin shoes on. I think they're like the 1461s. A very classic black shoe in menswear. It's just such a beautiful silhouette. The different layers of black, and then the fact that he's snatched in at the waist with that belt. It also looks like there's maybe some pleats in the trousers at the top just to help with that tapered fit. I believe Yeonjun's finished off the look with the black structured bag from look one. It looks a very similar shape. I have not got a clear shot of the bag, but it could potentially be that beautiful black structured leather bag. And I also like the fact that he's kept the accessories very clean, very minimal. He's just got his earrings in, there's no necklace, so it really keeps that lacy neckline clear and it keeps the texture difference very clear to the eye. And it also doesn't look like there's any rings or like bracelet or watch. It's just the belt, the bag, the earrings. It's very clean. It's all about the textures here. Yeonjun look three, again, it's a 10. Every outfit I've seen, I literally just wanna like take it. Take it. I will not even lie to you. On Pinterest, I started a board called Fall Winter 2021 Style Inspiration. And I was just saving all of these looks down for me to refer to later. But that is how much I love them, honestly. Yeonjun look four, he's killing me again with another statement coat look. This time we've got this beautiful camel coat. Again, that very structured, oversized fit on the shoulder. We can see that the shoulder pads are just coming past his natural shoulder. The sleeve is a really nice fit, coming down just to the top of his hand. And then even the body of the coat, it's this really nice, perfectly oversized cut. The notch lapel, it's the perfect proportion for the coat. And the break, it starts quite high up, which is where your lapel folds back into the jacket. And then we can see it's got the dark buttons going down. This is an SB3 technically, but it's got that really nice oversized fit. And I believe that there is a belt zooming in. You can see a belt hidden behind the sleeve, and that's just going to give a really nice snatch silhouette when you do it up. And I also find coats that have a belt around the waist, they always keep you warmer because you're like really like pulling the coat in. Looking at Yeonjun's pink mullet, I'm guessing this is from the Blue Hour era, and this is definitely what it's giving me, like the statement long coat, that fit of the jean, the white boots, the fact he's got his like hand in the pocket. It's just making me think of the dance. So it's definitely that vibe. Looking at the white jersey, I can't tell if this is a t-shirt or a vest, but it's got this very nice scoop neckline. It's just very clean, very simple, tucked into a pair of jeans that he always seems to wear jeans and trousers that sit right on the top of his hips, and it just really helps to elongate the leg. And they look like a really nice slim cut. There's not much difference between the width of the ankle and the thigh. And then the white boots with that cleated sole. The patent white boot is just a really nice touch. Easily could have done a black boot, it would have looked good, but the white boot really balances out the look because he's got the white top underneath the coat. It's just a really nice shoe, and you don't really see a lot of men in white boots. We need to see more of it. Yeonjun look 4, it's 10 rings from me. I'm handing out lots of 10s in this video, but for me, this is styled perfectly. It's that perfect smart casual vibe, and then the touch of the white boot, it just really elevates the look. This is such a fantastic one to recreate in both men's and women's wear. You know, it's August. We are going to be creeping into fall soon, especially here in the UK. A statement camel coat worn like this, a white top, jeans, white boots, or white sneakers, it's just such an essential fall winter look. It's also a great way to introduce tonal looks into your wardrobe. This camel coat with a really nice pair of beigey wide trousers and then like a neutral top, it's just very chic, very sleek. You can wear this coat in so many different ways, so it's an essential. Yeonjun look 5, he looks so bad. He looks fucking incredible. This leather blazer. And the first thing I noticed about this leather blazer is the fact that it's short sleeve. It finishes at the elbow. It's just a really nice silhouette. It's a nice point of difference. Leather blazers were a huge trend before just gone. I can see them being a huge trend continuing into this fall coming. I feel like basically my fall winter wardrobe is just going to be a lot of leather at this point. And I'm okay with that. Looking at the leather blazer, we can see that this is a slightly more fitted cut. We haven't got the oversized shoulder. It's fitting him perfectly to his natural shoulder. We've got that set-in seam, the sleeve right to the elbow. This is a notch lapel, which is where your lapel pieces are the same width as your collar pieces, like this here. And then it's got those two jetted chest pockets. It's got the two buttons, the patch pockets on the hips. Looking at the length of the blazer, it is slightly cropped than where a normal blazer would finish. We can see this is finishing at the top of his thigh. It's such a great silhouette. I love the fact that he's put this black belt around the waist. It has this beautiful buckle where it's got that big clip in the gold. It just really contrasts and stands out. And he's not put the belt around so tight that it's like snatching him in. It's just to help define that waist. And it's just fucking great styling. I like the fact that he's got the white t-shirt underneath. This is where I would have liked to have seen a necklace, even if it was just like a little small one. I think it just would have really like added like something here. It still works very clean, but like even just like a little bit of this. Yeonjun has then finished off the look with a pair of black slim cut trousers. I don't have a shot where I can see what's on his feet, but I'm sure it'll be something black, something great, hopefully a boot. Oh, that would have looked good. Or those Dr. Martin shoes, that would still look fantastic. And then looking at the shoulder strap, I think he's got that black statement leather bag that we've seen in two of his previous looks. Yeonjun knows the way to my heart through style. I love this. Yeonjun look 5, I'm gonna give this 9 wings. I've given 4 looks 10s, and for me, this would have been a 10 with just like a little necklace or like just something around the neck just to like really like punch it up a notch. Our final Yeonjun look, I had to finish on another statement coat, and I feel like Yeonjun just loves a statement coat as much as me. Looking at this look here, it is a shirling coat that's got this really incredible black and white print to it. It's very urban, it's very cool. It looks like he's folded the collar up. To me, it looks like a notch lapel collar because you can see the lapel and the collar pieces are the same width. It's just been flipped up, so it's giving him that warmth around the neck. I can't really see too many other details because of the print. I'm assuming that it's got button fastenings, maybe 3 or 4, where it's quite a long coat. It looks like there is a wrist strap going around the wrist, so it's just a very clean silhouette, and it's letting the fabric and the texture of the fabric and the print do all of the work here. This has then been styled very, very similarly to our first look. We've got that black roll neck jumper is tucked into jeans. This is a very slim cut pair of jeans with that same, they could even be the same jeans actually, looking at where the wash is on the thigh. It looks like he's got those black pointed Chelsea boots on, and we can see that he's carrying that same structured black bag. You know I love it when we see idols carrying the same accessories or re-wearing pieces. Fashion is not made to be thrown away, especially when you're investing money in it. I'm gonna give our final Yeonjun look 6. I'm gonna give this 8.5 wings. It's a fantastic look. It's been styled really well, but there are just other looks for me that I'm like, yes, like that is the vibe. This is still a vibe, but the other looks are a vibe. I am in love with Yeonjun's style. It absolutely floored me. Like I said, I had no expectations going into this and I got hit with a truck. Obsessed. Please let me know in the comments what your favorite look from today's video has been. I think mine is either look number 1, that statement leather trench coat, or it has to be look number 3, all black, the beautiful silhouette and the different textures. If you've made it this far into the video, you should definitely hit that subscribe button and give the video a thumbs up. But what you should do next is go check out my BTS red carpet outfit review. I'll leave a little link up here for you guys. This is part 1. I said part 2 was coming on the 22nd of August, but I'm considering not doing that and uploading it sooner. You'll see, I guess you'll find out. But thank you so much for watching, and a massive, massive thank you to everyone who has subscribed. You are bloody amazing, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye guys.